That white car way up there. Driver's gonna end up leaning on top of him. Got the blinker on. There's no room here. Watch this lane change. We're gonna move over to the right just to show you this. We're gonna fall back. Can't even see that car. Back over to the left. Can't even see that car. That's how close he is. You can see the shadow of the car up there, barely. Over to the right. I'm going to see if we can get you another glance at that car. There it is. You can still barely see it there. That is less than 1 second. You may end up losing some road speed. I'm going to move over to the left. It's exit 20. Moving over to the right. Cleveland, Tennessee. So now he's gonna close up his following distance there. This truck just goes too fast for this truck, for this driver. There's truck really, the most other trucks out here don't do 73 miles an hour. Gonna fall back, make some room. Down that hill. So this is less than 1 second following distances that we observe your driver get in the short time we've had this video on. So since other trucks, major fleet lines, they don't go this fast, so what happens, your driver is always in, well, virtually always in, a less than one. He runs down on one vehicle, just does whatever the max that truck does, and that's how he gets himself into those situations. Probably does 73 or so. And then when he goes down a hill, obviously he gets more speed. Another example. We got this England up here. This England isn't going to do 74 miles an hour, 73. We're falling back because we know your driver's just going to want some room. Got that signal on. He's moving over sooner. Cancel the signal. Let's give you a current location right here. This is Cleveland, Tennessee. Right now it's 10:41 a.m. Today's the 22nd of September. to jump back over here. This is a restricted lane for this truck. Off to the left. Just get a couple cars here. Car in there. There. A little bit of rain and showers coming on through. We're going to move over to the right. Of our speed with your truck. We're gonna fall back here. Which is lane change. So it seems like every vehicle he gets, when he moves over, he just gets right up close to another vehicle. Doesn't leave any following distance whatsoever. This type of driving is going to hurt his start, stop. That's 50 at 62 miles an hour. You're going to end up popping somebody in the tail. It's just a matter of time. Going to move on over again. Or he's going to make a lane change collision by not letting the signal actuate enough, get people notice, just kind of slaps a blinker on and moves over. Discoloration from the rain and showers that have come through. I'm gonna come on back over. There's a white van up there. How much room he has that white van? And he's gonna end up closing it up.